Hello everyone, let us continue our discussion on quadratic equations. Next problem, solve the quadratic equation x square minus 4x minus 21 equal to 0 by completing square method. Once again question, solve the quadratic equation x square minus 4x minus 21 is equal to 0 by completing square method. Just by completing square method. Solve this quadratic equation by completing square method. By method of completing square, first make the coefficient of x square as 1. If it is not, suppose coefficient of x square is not equal to 1, then make it 1. If it is already 1, then no problem. Then directly go for next step. In this case, already coefficient of x square is 1 only. Minus 4x. Take half of the coefficient of x. Take half of the coefficient of x. In this case, what is coefficient of x? Minus 4x. Minus 4x means coefficient of x is minus 4. What is its half? Minus 2. Take its square. Half of the coefficient of x, square, add and subtract. Minus 21, that's equal to 0. Take half of the coefficient of x, square, add and subtract. After that, or let's write one more step. X square minus 4x plus 4 minus 4 minus 21, that's equal to 0. Now look at first three terms. X square plus 4x plus 4 clearly it is expansion of x minus 2 whole square. First three terms is always a perfect square. That is x minus 2 whole square. This is expansion of x minus 2 whole square. Simplify these two constant terms. Minus 4 minus 21, it will be minus 25. That's equal to 0. Now, x minus 2 whole square is equal to 25. Then x minus 2 equal to plus or minus square root of 25. Then x minus 2 is equal to plus or minus 5. After that, x equal to plus 5 plus 2 or x equal to minus 5 plus 2. Plus or minus means once consider positive and once consider negative. Lastly, you get x equal to 7 or x equal to minus 3. Therefore, required roots are seven and minus 3 by the method of completing square. Quadratic equation by completing square. For solving quadratic equation, we have three methods. One is by factorization, other one by completing square, and third type or third method by using quadratic formula. Next problem. Solve the quadratic equation. solve the quadratic equation 2x square minus 6x 2x square minus 6x plus 3 equal to 0 by completing square method. By completing square, solve the quadratic equation by completing square method. Same method is followed. What we do, first make the coefficient of x square as plus 1 by the method of completing square. Just dividing each term by 2, then it will be x square minus 3x plus 3 divided by 2 equal to 0. In the first step, make the coefficient of x square as plus 1. In the first step, make the coefficient of x square as plus 1. After that, in the second step, take half of the coefficient of x square, add and subtract. In this case, what is coefficient of x? Minus 3 is coefficient of x. And its half is minus 3 by 2, square, add and subtract. X square minus 3x plus minus 3 by 2 whole square. Take half of the coefficient of x square, add and subtract. Minus 3 by 2, half of the coefficient of x, take its square. Minus 3 by 2 whole square, minus 3 by 2 whole square. Plus 3 by 2 remains as it is, that's equal to 0. I am saying one more step. X square minus 3x plus 9 divided by 4 minus 9 divided by 4 plus 3 by 2. Now look at first three terms. Clearly it is a perfect square and it is clearly expansion of x minus 3 divided by 2 whole square expansion is. Clearly it is like a square minus 2ab plus b square. In this case a value x, b value 3 by 2. Minus, just taking LCM. LCM of 4 and 2. Taking LCM R and send it to RHS. Then it will be 9 divided by 4 minus 3 by 2. Now, x minus 3 divided by 2 whole square is equal to, taking LCM, it will be 9 minus 6 divided by 4. Then it will be x minus 3 by 2 whole square is equal to 9 minus 6, that is 3 divided by 4. Then we need x value. So x minus 3 by 2 whole square is there. I will write x minus 3 by 2 is equal to plus or minus square root of 3 divided by 4 means x equal to plus or minus square root of 3 divided by 2 plus 3 divided by 2. Send it to RHS. Then x equal to plus root 3 divided by 2 plus 3 by 2. Or x equal to minus root 3 by 2 plus 3 by 2. Therefore, x equal to root 3 plus 3 whole thing by 2, or x equal to minus root 3 plus 3 whole thing divided by 2. Now required roots are root 3 plus 3 divided by 2 and minus root 3 plus 3 divided by 2. Roots of this quadratic equation by method of completing square. Next we will discuss method of solving quadratic equation by quadratic formula. We need to find roots of the quadratic equation ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0 by using quadratic formula. First we shall find roots of this quadratic equation by completing square, or just find the formula for finding roots of this quadratic equation. Ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0, it is one of the quadratic formula, standard form of the quadratic equation. Now ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0, we need to find the roots of this quadratic equation just by completing square method. Just by completing square. In completing square, what we do? First, make the coefficient of x square as 1. For that, dividing each term by a, then it becomes x square plus b divided by a into x plus c divided by a is equal to 0. After that, making perfect square or by completing square method. Complete the square means it should be a perfect square. Make this equation as a perfect square. Next step, x square plus b by a into x plus, take half of the coefficient of x. What is coefficient of x in this case? B by a is coefficient. This is our coefficient of x. Take its half, means divided by 2, means b divided by 2a is half of the coefficient of x. Square, add and subtract, means b by 2a whole square and minus b by 2a whole square plus c by a as it is, that's equal to 0. Now look at first three terms. First three terms is a perfect square. Clearly it is like x square means a square plus 2ab plus b square, means it is expansion of x minus b by a, b by 2a whole square. It is expansion of x plus b by 2a whole square, sorry, it is plus. It is expansion of x plus b by 2a whole square expansion. Remaining term, send it to RHS. B square by 4a square. Okay, because this is minus b square by 4a square, send it to RHS, then it will be plus. Minus c divided by a. After that, in RHS, just take the LCM. X plus b by 2a whole square is equal to, what will be the LCM? For a square is the LCM, means b square minus 4ac divided by 4a square. After taking LCM, we get b square minus 4ac divided by 4a square. After that, we need x value, so x plus b by 2a is equal to plus or minus square root of b square minus 4ac whole thing divided by 4a square, because of it is like x square equal to some value, is x equal to plus or minus. Then x plus b by 2a is equal to plus r minus square root of b square minus 4ac whole thing divided by 2a. Why? Because square root of 4a square will be 2a. Then we need x value, so x equal to send it to RHS means it is minus b by 2a plus r minus b square root of b square minus 4ac divided by 2a. Now x equal to minus b plus r minus square root of b square minus 4ac divided by 2a. These two are roots of given quadratic equation. Means two roots, x equal to one of the root is minus b plus square root of b square minus 4ac whole thing divided by 2a, or x equal to minus b minus square root of b square minus 4ac whole thing divided by 2a. These two are roots of this quadratic equation, and I will take one of the root as alpha. Just name of these roots, one of the root is alpha, just rename it. Instead of x, one of the root is taken as alpha, other root is beta. Instead of taking x, I will take roots as alpha and beta. Minus b plus square root of b square minus 4ac whole thing divided by 2a, or other root is taken as beta. Minus b minus of square root of b square minus 4ac whole thing divided by 2a. Other two roots, sorry, two roots are, one of the root is taken as alpha, other root is taken as beta. Roots of quadratic equation ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0 is, one is alpha, other one is beta. These two are roots of given quadratic equation. Sometimes we need some of the roots. Just remember this part. Relationship between coefficients and roots. We need to find alpha plus beta value. Already we have alpha value and beta value. Sum of the roots of any quadratic equation is denoted with alpha plus beta. Sum of the roots of given quadratic equation is taken as alpha plus beta. Already we have alpha value and beta value. Alpha value minus b plus of square root of b square minus 4ac whole thing divided by 2a plus, what is beta value? Minus b minus of square root of b square minus 4ac whole thing divided by 2a. Now taking LCM, it will be minus b plus square root of b square minus 4ac minus b minus square root of b square minus 4ac whole thing divided by 2a. Now these two terms will be getting answered equal with opposite inside. Now minus b will be minus 2b divided by 2a. 2 to get cancelled. We get minus b divided by a. Sum of any roots, sum of the roots alpha plus beta is minus b by a. Alpha plus beta is equal to minus b by a, that's equal to. What is b? Negative sign as b is nothing but coefficient of x divided by constant term. Sorry, a is nothing but coefficient of x square. Coefficient of x square. And just remember minus b by a gives sum of the roots of the given quadratic equation. And similarly, we need one more condition: product of the roots. Alpha into beta value we want. Second one, alpha into beta. What is alpha into beta value? Already we have alpha value as well as beta value. Just take their product. Take alpha into beta. That is minus b plus square root of b square minus 4ac whole thing divided by 2a into replace beta value. It will be minus b minus of square root of b square minus 4ac whole thing divided by 2a. Now take usual product. Denominator 2a into 2a is 4a square. Numerator is like a plus b. Treat minus b as a. It is like a plus b, a minus b. So it will be a square. Means instead of a, we have minus b. Minus b whole square minus square root of b square minus 4ac whole square. Numerator is like a plus b and a minus b, so it will be a square minus b square. Whole thing divided by denominator 2a into 2a, it will be 4a square. That's equal to minus b whole square is plus b square. Minus b square minus 4ac. By using root and square will be get cancelled. Remains with b square minus 4ac. Whole thing divided by 4a square. After that, b square minus b square plus 4ac whole thing divided by 4a square. Now b square get cancelled. 4ac divided by 4a square means we get c divided by a. Product of the roots of quadratic equation is c by a. Alpha into beta are product of the roots. Product of the roots equal to c divided by a. C is nothing but constant of divided by coefficient of x square. Sum of the roots is minus b by a. Product of the roots is c by a. Just remember these two formulas. Alpha value, alpha plus beta, alpha into beta. Sum of the roots and product of the roots. If you take product of roots of any quadratic equation, it is always equal to c divided by a. If you take sum of roots of any quadratic equation, that c is always equal to minus b by a. Next, discriminant. Next point. What is discriminant of the quadratic equation? And it is denoted with delta. It is notation for discriminant of the quadratic equation. And what is definition of discriminant? The expression b square minus 4ac. The expression b square minus 4ac is called discriminant of the quadratic equation. The expression b square minus 4ac or discriminant is denoted with delta. Delta is equal to b square minus 4ac. The expression b square minus 4ac is called discriminant of the quadratic equation. Based on this discriminant, we conclude whether real roots are exist or equal roots are exist or complex roots are exist or real roots are not exist. That is depends on nature of b square minus 4ac. Nature of the roots. nature of the roots depends on discriminant of the quadratic equation, whether it is positive or negative or zero. The whether discriminant of the quadratic equation is zero or discriminant of the quadratic equation is positive or negative. Nature of the roots depends on b square minus 4ac. And b square minus 4ac is called discriminant of the quadratic equation. And one more very important concept, nature of the roots. Let us study nature of the roots for the quadratic equation. Which type of roots are exist, whether they are equal or unequal or real or not real, that is depends on b square minus 4ac. First point, if b square minus 4ac equal to 0, suppose discriminant equal to 0, then implies, this is simple for then. If b square minus 4ac equal to 0, then roots are real and equal. Real and equal. When roots are equal, then clearly discriminant of the quadratic equation is equal to 0. And second point, if b square minus 4ac greater than 0, what is meaning of greater than 0? Greater than 0 means any positive value, less than 0 means any negative value. Greater than 0 means any positive value or any positive real number. B square minus 4ac is greater than 0. Roots are real and distinct, means different, unequal roots, real and distinct, means unequal. Then b square minus 4ac positive, then roots are real but unequal, they are not equal. If b square minus 4ac equal to 0, then both the roots are equal. Unequal. And third condition, if b square minus 4ac is less than 0, then less than 0 means any negative value, then roots are imaginary. Are real roots not exist? Are not exist when a discriminant is negative. Very important points. When discriminant equal to 0, both the roots are equal and real, are real and equal. When b square minus 4ac is positive, b square minus 4ac is positive, then the roots are real roots and unequal, real and unequal. If b square minus 4ac is equal to negative value, then imaginary roots, means real roots, are not exist. Thank you.